Mother, no. Speaking to GMA overnight.
We can blame somebody else, we can blame ourselves, but Elijah is who we're all trying to get to be.
McLean died after being in police custody nearly a year ago. His case now is being re-examined in the wake of other high-profile police killings.
The fact that it has taken the death of a man across the country to finally cause Coloradans to stand up, to look into a death caused by its own officers back in August is atrocious.
The family's attorney says McLean was walking home after buying iced tea from a corner store when this call about a suspicious person was made to the Aurora PD in Colorado. Three officers responded to the call. McLean is seen walking on the sidewalk when officers approach him.
Stop! Stop!
One officer is heard telling McLean to stop. Things escalate when McLean allegedly attempted to grab an officer's gun. The officers then subdue him to the ground and troll hold, a move that restricts blood flow to the brain. McLean begs for relief, even uttering those eerily too familiar words.
I can't breathe.
First responders arrive shortly after and administer ketamine, an anesthetic meant to rapidly tranquilize.
It's standard protocol for the paramedics to inject ketamine.
McLean went into cardiac arrest on the way to the hospital, where he stayed 5 days before ultimately being taken off life support. A coroner determined his cause of death undetermined.
A young man, a young African-American man, should be allowed to walk home wearing a mask, waving his arms to music, but that absolutely should not be a death sentence.
The district attorney is open to taking another look at the case, but says it's going to take more than a petition.
You know, if there is something out there that we missed, I will certainly take a look at it, but it's got to be something that's relevant to the investigation. But the passion that's going on with this case and the petition that's out there is not something I can base my decision on.
All right, the governor says he's going to have his office try to look into this. And Stray, this is worth noting. You will remember, at the beginning of the pandemic, when we were being encouraged to wear masks, there were black men that came out so because they'd be looked at with suspicion. Well, Elijah McLean was wearing a ski mask. He has a condition called anemia, which causes him to sometimes feel cold. I hate to even explain that, as if I have to explain his behavior, but he did nothing wrong that night, and a 911 call came about him being sketchy.
And you shouldn't have to explain it, TJ. And there's a video from April that was just released of a man dying in police custody in Arizona.
This is getting new attention as well. The police chief out there has offered his resignation, but yes, a 911 call about Carlos Ingram Lopez is his name. Officers showed up, three of them. They have now resigned. The police department said they did not follow protocol. The officers are calling this a horrible death. The police chief is, he's offered his resignation, but he died after being restrained on the ground for 12 minutes, pleading and begging for some help. And yes, in fact, he was saying he could not breathe. Sure.
I'm having this conversation too much, TJ. Thank you. George.
Sure, Michael. We move on now to an ABC News exclusive.